Tonight on Sydney's Soapbox, we're asking, should politicians be paid more? Let us know your views on Facebook, Twitter or email.
In a moment, we'll hear what the barefoot investor Scott Pape has to say. But first, here's the view from the city.
The Prime Minister and those around her should probably be paid more. I think some of the other ones around them maybe should be reviewed.
No way. No way they should be paid less.
I don't know what I think, really, because the politicians, it's always been less than the industry rate, isn't it?
I would answer with no, because they're not really doing anything to help Australia prosper right now, so why should they get more money?
Politicians? I think they get overpaid.
I'm not sure. Maybe it should be judged individually on what they've achieved in the year.
The thing is, they make much less than a CEO in a big company. So I guess if you want to avoid corruption, maybe, why not?
This is really a carrot and a donkey argument, and I mean that in the nicest way. Scott Papers, we introduce you. Not that I'm comparing pollies to donkeys or carrots. Should they be paid more?
Absolutely not. I mean, I know there is an argument that if you pay peanuts, you get monkeys, but I think there's a much bigger danger, and that is turning the job of being a politician into a career. And I think we'd all agree the last thing we want is more career politicians. Our two leaders now, Julia Gillard and Tony Abbott, are career politicians. They were in student politics and they graduated to full-time politics. And I think as taxpayers who are ultimately paying for our constituents to be there, we should be encouraging people who have had a life outside of politics, who have built businesses and employed people and who are pulled into public office, not because of the perks and the pay, but because they have a real desire to see things changed. That's what I think we need to be doing.
So, Scott, a question then. If you're offering people more money, you might end up with more career politicians. So, in the end, how do you stop that?
Well, I think it comes down to us. We're the ones who vote and we're obviously the taxpayers who are paying these people. We need to look at our constituents and say, are they in line with our community values? Have they actually built something? Do they actually have the ability to make decisions on behalf of us? And if they're a career politician, they may be great at playing politics, but not so much about representing our interests. So at the end of the day, we're in a democracy. It comes back to us.
Good advice. Scott Pape, thank you.